Ja, welkom bij Music in the Backyard, waarin aandacht wordt besteed aan muziek die je niet in alle grote concertzalen zult zien, maar misschien wel in kleine cafés of kleinere concertzaaltjes, of misschien zelfs wel bij jouw buurman of buurvrouw in de achtertuin. En ik sta hier bij Café de Herberg in Oosterleek, vlak aan het IJsselmeer. En elke zondagmiddag is daar de Folk Club. En vanmiddag spelen daar The Watchmen en Jack Clement. Nou, The Watchmen is een vrij bekende Nederlandse folk-Americana-band. En Jack Clement is echt een legende. Het is echt geweldig dat hij hier in dit kleine dorpje Oosterleek speelt. Jack Clement is de man die het geluid bepaalde in de Sun Studios, waar Elvis begonnen is. Jerry Lee Lewis, Johnny Cash, noem ze allemaal maar op. Roy Orbison, die zijn allemaal in de Sun Studio begonnen. Jack Clement heeft het geluid bepaald voor Sun Studio. Great Balls of Fire, Whole Lot of Shaking Going On. Het was Jack Clement die daar achter de knoppen zat. En deze man speelt vanmiddag hier in de herberg, in de Folk Club in Oosterleek. En we gaan genieten van zijn optreden. Ik ben heel benieuwd wat hij gaat doen. Natuurlijk is hij niet meer zo ruig als dat hij vroeger was. Hij heeft trouwens heel veel andere dingen gedaan. Maar waarschijnlijk zullen we daar deze middag niet al te veel van merken. Ik ga naar binnen, want ik ben heel benieuwd wat er gaat gebeuren. Oké, doei. Naast Jack Clement. Jack, welcome here in Oosterleek.
Oh, thank you.
You're playing here in this this small venue here in Oosterleek together with the Watchmen.
Right. Yeah.
And you play, do you do a lot of shows?
I don't
nowadays?
Do a whole lot. I do a few. But mostly I'm behind the scenes producing, writing, that sort of thing. And I play guitar in a lot of sessions, you know, especially Johnny Cash stuff and all that.
You played and you worked with all those guys, all those famous guys, Elvis, Johnny Cash, Jerry Lee Lewis. What does it do to you in your career?
Well, I had a lot of fun, I know that.
I can believe that.
Yeah, well, it was great. I started working at Sun Records in 1956.
Yeah.
And I produced Jerry Lee's first records and a whole bunch of his things. And a lot of Johnny Cash songs. And I wrote several of them, Ballad of a Teenage Queen and Guess Things Happen That Way.
Yeah.
And I played guitar with him a lot. In fact, I was playing with him right up until a week or so before he passed away.
Long ago and far away, all the common labor's here. Yeah.
Fly with Jerry Lewis. And did you knew at that moment that that was magic, that moment? What did you felt at the moment you recorded the song?
Well, actually, that song we recorded on two or three different occasions. We all knew it was a hit song. He loved it, I loved it, everybody loved it. And we tried it two or three times, you know, until we got it right. That's what we used to do back then. We weren't cutting albums so much back in those days, going for singles. So we'd work on the song, and if it didn't come off, we'd do it two or three weeks later when we got back together. On the other hand, Great Balls, Whole Lot of Shaking Going On, that was one take.
Just one take.
One take. We'd been working on a song I wrote, a song a while ago called It'll Be Me. And I was in the control room and getting kind of bored with it. And I went out in the studio and said, let's do something else for a while. Come back to this. And his bass player said, hey, Jerry, do that song we've been doing on the road that everybody likes so much.
Yeah, yeah.
He said, okay. I said, well, let me record it. I went back in the control room, turned the machine on, and they did a whole lot of shaking.
That must have been a magic moment.
Yeah, it was. No, that's the first time I'd ever heard the song. Yeah. They didn't even run it down. We just cut it, you know, and that was it. One take.
And the rest is history.
Yeah, right.
Then one day, the teenage star sold her house and all her cars, gave up all her wealth and fame, left it all and caught a train.
Left it all and caught a train.
Next day, she was at the door of the lonely boy next door, who works at the candy store.
Now the story has some more.
Thank you very much.